at what point does reincarnation end? Is there anything after it?
Okay. If reincarnation was forever and ever and ever and ever, means you go around and around the mulberry bush, it'll be tiresome, it'll be a prison. Fortunately, that is not the case. Reincarnation only continues as long as you feel there is tremendous amount of unfulfilled or frustrated desires within your system that have not been put to rest. So because of this tremendous drive that you have, this is what keeps you going in reincarnation. Because look, we all know we've got so many frustrations. We wanted this and it didn't happen. We wanted, we desired that and that is not coming through. So all these things remain in us in a very strong driving force. And this can only come to, and that's why you get reincarnated. Because once you give up one body, you say, still so many things to sort out. So you look for another, if you like, manifestation, another kind of way of, you know, experiencing this physical body. So you're reincarnated. And this goes on until you say something is wrong here. I mean, if it was forever, it's horrendous, it's terrible, it's a prison. But fortunately, this is what happens with enlightened personality, with this Buddha or the Hindu prophets, etc. They say, when we discover our true nature, you know, I've been talking about the spirit, you as your true nature, when we actually, not then just believe it, actually experience it, somehow, we don't have to bottle up desires, we don't have to avoid desires, we don't get frustrated, desires just drop off, like, you know, autumn leaves, they just fall off. In the same way, desires drop off. And then when desires drop off, the thing that is there has no desire to be reborn. So if you like, this idea of reincarnation comes to an end. It can come any moment. Any of you can get it any moment. You get that experience, desires drop off, then what reincarnation? And sometimes you get even living in your body. The desires have been dropped off, but you still live in the body until it drops off by itself. And so these are marvelous individuals. They are called Jivan Mukta. They live in this body, and yet they have overcome the idea they are the body. And the best example, as I said, in recent times, Ramana Maharshi, look up his life. A person with no desires and yet fully, you know, enlightened. And yet the body carries on. He eats, drinks, he talks, he chats. And yet there's no attachment to the body even. When you do an operation, he says, cut the body. I'm not the body. You don't need anesthetic. You say, what kind of human being is this? This is real stories. And this is, if you like, the idea of... So it's not, by the way, let me tell you, people somehow feel that when you finish reincarnation, we like desires, we like to fulfill and chase after them, but at some stage they do become tiresome. And when they become tiresome for you, it's time, in fact, you know, have you noticed another thing I've seen? In all the kind of, you know, betting shops, they put a sign which says, when the fun stops, stop. Saying that when the gambling gets too much, stop, when it becomes painful. So when the fun stops, stop, said the gambling, you know, the betting shops. So I'm telling the same. When the desire says stop, enough is enough, I don't want it, then time comes to stop. Then you stop automatically.